Starting in just a couple minutes here. Gonna be the final match. It's gonna determine first and second place. Two teams, Vanilla and Alde versus Pororo and Mishka. Oh. And just play a little bit of music here, I think. I just find the rank. Oh, and I think and if Amionia is going to stop streaming, I will go to her channel, see if anybody else. Streaming ranked. Okay, let's play all shuffle. Okay, it's a little bit loud, I think. Yeah, I think that's fine. Starting here soon. Please let me know if there's an issue with the balancing or anything. I don't think there is. It looks all right. Just looking at the volume levels. Can I err on the side of the music being too silent? Too low volume? All right. You go in here. Oh, yeah. Share my screen here, so hopefully this doesn't cause any issues. Share my screen on Discord. Feel free to join in on the commentary if you want, Yuki. I am on Twitch, though, just so you're aware. I would definitely welcome your commentary if you want to, but I just wanted you to be aware of that. Because you may not want your voice to be heard on Twitch. Okay, what do we got? Oh, they're all starting out with a very nice looking hand here. And also, LA has some good shapes there, and some trash as well. Yushika building some stuff up. Yeah, look at that. 5, 6, 7, 8. 6, 7, 8. Pretty decent. Getting a nice draw there. I guess, 5, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8. That's like, that's some nice symmetry. Kind of inefficient use of tiles, I think. And Pororo. Oh, Pororo, I missed that call somehow. Yeah, Pororo probably can finish pretty fast here. The canned is currently looking a bit trash, but and calls so many things that probably will get a cheap hand here pretty quick and just end this dealership. Probably the idea. Well, the south is Yakuhai too, right? So if Pororo can manage to pick up a red 5, and I guess could also use the Dora, be a little bit, yeah, at this point, could pick up the Dora and drop off the 1-3 and end up getting a 4 Han hand that way. Oh, and actually just in Tenpai for 2 Han hand. This is not going to be used. Could call the Chun and wait on the 1. It's another option. Not a good option, but based on what we see here, it would be a good option if we couldn't see that all the 1s are already gone. Already being used. Oh, Chanta. I didn't even see the Chanta. Yes, that's pretty good. Pretty good. And so many food there. That's what really made that good. I didn't realize how much the food were adding up. Alright, so what's going on? Porto, getting a nice draw there next to the 7. Yushika has a pretty nice looking hand, I think. Yeah, pretty alright. Yeah, but Vanilla's hand, all those honor tiles, and only one pair. Yeah, just gonna go for a Honitsu, looks like. A little skeptical if that Honitsu will complete. There's so many trash tiles there to get rid of. If Vanilla draws even one of those, though, like that, drawing that Hatsu really changes things quite a bit. Adding another entire shape to the hand for another Honitsu shape. So yeah, that may have been partially a bluff just to instantly open up. But I know Vanilla just tends to be really aggressive anyway. So yeah, that definitely worked out. How far away is the Yushika? The 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 really, really could use a 7 mon or a 2 so, or yeah, filling in some of those gaps there. But that's one away, right? And that 7 mon would be Itsu. So obviously, would really like to get that 7 mon and could just Richie waiting on the 7 mon, given the value of the hand. That'd be really nice, because if Pororo and Yushika both win a hand early on, like, they'll have... Oh, look at that, look at that. No Richie. In a Tuhan hand in Dama. And just deals in. Yeah. That's pretty valuable. I mean, it does end the opponent's... It does end the dealership, but it's taking 2,600 more points from the opponents. Getting a pretty significant lead here, and it's 2, he's 3. So the game is already like almost, it's getting close to like half over. They've got a lead, they're looking pretty good for them. That's probably why Yushika felt okay just taking a Dama there for his tiny hand, and their dealership. And Vanilla getting another Honitsu looking hand. And again, would really like to draw another one of those honor tiles. That four really goes against the Honitsu. Vanilla's staying with it. I think in that position, I would have just dropped the north. Like, it's not worth that much. Because, yeah, could just end up doing a Richi on a Impu hand. Well, that's actually Yakuhai. So, the 4-5 is not useless. They could at least end the dealership here. And a 3-Han Honitsu, whatever. It's really, really doubtful that north will actually come into play. So having a 4-5 versus having a north that you probably won't use, like, what else is going on here? Well, it has 2 Dora. Hand doesn't really look like it's going to complete. Pororo. Very nice looking hand that Pororo has. Drawing that 777, the kind of awkward in shapes there. Well, 567, 77, is that the only pair? Yeah, that's actually really good. And that is Tenpai. Thinking of doing a Richie waiting on the 3-mon. I was thinking that was like just an awkward shape, but actually gives Tenpai because that's the only pair, that 7s. I just assume there's a pair somewhere. Like, out of all those tiles, there should at least be a pair, right? And actually, how close is... Yeah, Alde is actually really close too. Like, I didn't realize... Somehow I didn't see that 1, 2, 3 there. 1, 2, 3, 8, 8, 8. The hand looked a lot worse than it actually is. That's a nice draw, getting rid of that Kanchan. So yeah, Alde is really close. Vanilla still has that nice San Menshan. Could end up with a single weight on, like, the north. Well, the north is it would be a hell weight. That's not good. Single weight on the east. That's a nice draw. It's a nice draw for Yushika, but too far away. Probably will keep pushing due to being the dealer. this beautiful song. Oh, and yeah. How are they getting into a... getting under Tenpai with a weight that includes the Dora. Jumping weight including the Dora. Feels pretty safe that you can't put down the Dora yourself and deal in. So it feels a little bit safer to take that. As opposed to just some random crappy shampoo weight. And that's... okay, so yeah, Avanilla is going to wait on the east here, like I was saying. Yushika has to worry about Atsumo. But yeah, I don't know if Yushika is going to actually drop this east. That'd be pretty bad for them if he does, but I don't think that, unless he gets into... oh, actually very lucky there, huh? Is that Tenpai? I don't think it is, no. Yeah, so Yushika doesn't want to drop this one. Yeah, the one doesn't look particularly safe. Pororo is waiting on the... Pororo got in a Tenpai waiting on the... well, has been in Tenpai. Switched weight to the Forso. Very simple's hand. Oh, Yushika drew another East. just trying to think of what tile is not going to deal in. I wonder if Yushika will drop the East because it seems pretty safe. Yep, okay. Oh, man. Oh, boy. It's honestly kind of obnoxious, though. You shouldn't wait before run. Yeah. Oh boy. Yeah, that seems so safe. You don't think someone's gonna have a Tanki wait on the east? Like, yeah, that random. Nothing seems safe. So it's like having three easts. Like, yeah, that does seem like the safest thing. Doesn't seem completely safe, but compared to like three so or one so or something. Like, yeah. Yeah, that's why Yushika had such a hard time figuring out what do you drop there, because like, not any single tile seemed safe. The safest thing was thinking that the last east probably is probably in the wall, or someone just is randomly holding onto it for some. Vanilla opening on the east again, not again opening again. This time on the east. Yushika. Yushika has a really nice looking hand, a fast looking hand. It would just be pretty small. I think the game is basically tied. It's really close. Oh, nice draw. Oh yeah, and Yushika going for, is going for Pin Fedora. Has a nice Ishanten. So yeah, I think Yushika has an advantage this hand, but we'll see what happens. Pororo also is really close, yeah. Somehow I didn't realize how open Pororo was there. That is Tenpai. Is that 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 3, 6 weight? We're going into Dama. Really wanting to end this dealership. Okay, and also, Pororo also in Tenpai? Yeah, I feel like if I were Yushika, even though it is really valuable to just win a hand here and end the dealership and go south one, yeah, I think if it were me, I would probably just Richie. Because it is Pinfu Dora. Oh boy. Oh god. They're just gonna deal in here. What else? For it's just one Han. Right? Yeah. It's nothing. Yeah. That ends out this dealership. I mean, that's kind of like, it was beneficial because probably, almost certainly, Yushika and Pororo would have won there. but yeah, ideally they would have wanted Alde to win, or just to go to exhaust it and get more points, because this is their last chance to get points, really. To actually, Alde's gonna have the of course Alde's gonna have the final dealerships. Yeah. Alde's hand looks really good, and so does Vanilla's. Yeah, I think they definitely have the advantage here, but we'll see who gets the lucky draws. The East all dispersed like this. Is someone going to draw the fourth East as a pair? Well, everyone is so reluctant to put down the Dora here. I think if I was Vanilla here, I would want to drop this Dora much sooner. Because it's like, look at the situation here. Like, this is what you worry about happening. But the further the game goes on, the more likely someone is to draw a pair of East, and then you drop the East. They open. Although it's not Yaku, it is South one. So I guess it does make sense that it's not as dangerous. And it is the Yakuai for Vanilla. So really, Kororo and Yushika are more incentivized to drop that. But, yeah. Now for Yushika, it may seem more just like a safe tile. As safe as that might seem, having dealt in earlier in this, a tanky weight on the east. Yeah, really bad Akabukure weight. Orpin. That bulging middle weight. And there's the last east. So now that's totally safe tile as far as Yushika is concerned. Yeah, they really want to take back the lead here. Going into South 2. Be very nice from Poro and Yushika's perspective to just win anything, take back that lead, have their two dealerships to gain more points. Yeah, it's really valuable to end this particular dealership, because that goes into like the phase of the game where they can start racking up points. And especially during Yushika's dealership, Kororo can feed Yushika. I don't know how much they may have coordinated that. But that will be an opportunity for Porto to feed Yushika to win small hands. Or Humba farming. The Humba farming strategy. Oh my god, look at this. Does anyone compete with this? Yushika does have a pair of Hatsu there. Maybe we'll just get lucky. Okay, did get the Hatsu right away. If Yushika manages to get fed here from Pororo has a faster looking hand though, and can go simple, so Pororo might get a simple hand. This 7-8 here is the problem. Yeah, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6, 7. Drawing a 7 or an 8 would be nice to get a pair there. Oh yeah. Actually managed to get that. So, yeah. They may end this dealership right here. 3, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. This is a very nice shape. Want to get rid of one of these diamond probably because of the overlap. And Vanilla's still pretty far away. I mean, one away. One away, but the bad shapes. So it's not really accurate to say far away. Kororo waiting on what? This Sanmenchan. No, not Sanmenchan. Why the? Looks like a Sanmenchan. First glance. But Vanilla has all of these fives. It's possible Vanilla will end up dropping one of these fives to use it as a pair. Kind of unlikely, but it could happen. More likely to input the tanky way, I think. Yeah. yeah, we have five. We have an eight there, an eight there, three fives here. Alda might just drop that. Alda seems pretty likely to drop that eight any second now, getting the tenpai. I think the likely thing that will happen here, yeah, just Alda just deals into Yushika, or not Yushika, Pororo, for a simple's Dora hand, which will give them a pretty significant lead because of the Uma. Oh no, they just got same thing, basically. Actually, the Uma doesn't favor them. They've got first and fourth, so the Uma are equal. So it's just average score that matters. So they had very, very close game still. I'm not even sure who's ahead here. It's basically tied. Basically, the game is tied. But they've got two dealerships. Pororo and Jushika have two dealerships. This team has one dealership, but they've got the last dealership. So again, the score's tied. So yeah, it seems very even right now. See what happens? I need to move over. I don't have anyone telling me that I've got like audio problems or anything. Oh, a few people in the room. So Hugh, this is gonna be a best out of three, so it could be two games or it could be three games. And you can feel free to chime in. Just be aware that we're on Twitch right now. My Pororo, pretty nice looking hand here. Is anyone else? Hey kitten. That was a nice draw that Vanilla just got. Hold on. 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wasn't that just dropping us on Minshan? Why not drop, I mean, I guess the option is to like drop the 6, 7 or something, like maybe, I guess it's not that big of a difference, getting rid of the Sanminchan versus getting rid of Dianmin. It's an entire tile of acceptance. So. But maybe wanted a mon or a pin weight in favor of a so weight. But oh, and there is 4, 5, 6. So that's still Ishan 10, right? No. Hold on. Oh, yeah. Okay, I just got confused there somehow. Maybe I got that San Minchan stuck in my head. Oh. Alde deals in. Ends their dealership. That may hurt them, though, because that puts Alde in. Well, no, it doesn't hurt them because now they're the ones that have first and fourth. Yeah. So, yeah, that doesn't make any difference. Just switch the positions around and end. It makes a difference in terms of ending that dealership. So now that was very beneficial, because they have the last dealership, and there's only one dealership left for their team. But this is Pororo's chance to feed Yushika. If Yushika can manage to get an open hand out of it, it looks like it can certainly become just a simple hand here. But of course, it'd be nice to actually get some value at some point. But oh yeah, Alde open here, so yeah, I think they would really like to race this. because if hey cat. Because if Vanilla deals into Alde here, that'll go into the final dealership. I guess I don't know, I'm talking about the final dealership a lot, but we have Noagatayame, so it doesn't really matter that much. Like, it's not like they can win a single hand and end the game. That's the entire reason we have Noagatayame. So this is a bad thing to be talking about. Basically, the game is just tied right now. Like, there's nothing else to say, really. The average score is about the same. The way you can look at the average score really easily is to compare how close the team is to 60k. So 37.7 plus 21.1 is going to be, like, it's going to be 50... hold on. It's going to be 58.8, right? Is that correct? which means they're actually behind by 1,200 points. terms of average score. And that's the difference between the teams right now. So it isn't quite tied. The other team, Vanilla and Owl, they do have a bit of a lead. Dushika does have a pretty nice hand here. Alde is one away, but it's not really a very good one away. Oh, gonna go into a single weight on the south. That's kind of bad for Dushika here, and also Potato. Either one of them could just drop that south. Maybe Dushika will also go for a single weight on the south. I think probably just gonna deal in, honestly. Maybe like that is Alde's wind. Might worry that Alde has two of those, and also might worry about that's what I was saying. Yeah, Vanilla might just deal in. It's probably lucky, because it's hard to imagine one of those souths wouldn't have come. Well, maybe they would have been scared of Alde having, especially Alde having like small winds or something. I don't remember if we could see the Norse or not, but maybe they were worried about small winds, because Alde could have had three Norse and a single south, for instance, or could have had two souths and one north, and then giving him the souths gives tempi for small winds. Could have been something like that. So that maybe they would have been really scared of actually putting down that south. But yeah, it's come down to this. So if Potoro or Yushiko win this hand, they're going to win the game. Because basically the game has remained tied since the game has remained tied since like three rounds ago, and it's basically tied. Like they have a lead, but like in order for the other team to not take the lead back, they need to like win the smallest of hands possible, like sumo 100 or something like that. Like certainly that can happen to Potoro's hand right there. Potoro needs to get a door or something, or a direct hit would be fine. Right, because actually I think he needs more points than that. Because if Potoro wins a 1,000-point hand, oh, already? Hold on, what's going on with that 7? That's stealing into Vanilla. Vanilla's already in tempi. So yeah, I think that if Potoro wins a 1,000-point hand off the other team, they still, that would be 38,700, which is not quite over 60k, so that would not be enough. So actually, Potoro doesn't even have the option to win the sand. Needs to get that Dora. Needs to call that the six pin there. I was waiting on the six pin, right? But Potoro is in tempi waiting on this. I got kind of distracted there. I didn't realize that Potoro is actually in tempi waiting on a hand that will win the game. If that six comes from anyone except Yushika, a sumo? Would a sumo be enough? I think it would be, because it would be more than 1,200 points from the other team. Okay. That's gonna end it. Okay. We can verify that they have more points, but yeah, I'm sure that Vanilla and Alde just barely won. If we add up these points here. Right, we look at Vanilla and Alde, it's gonna be, yeah, they're just barely above zero. We look at Potoro and Yushika, they're just barely below. So yeah. Very close game. Came down to whoever won a tiny hand in that last match. Vanilla and Alde did have an advantage in that they could win literally anything. But yeah, it was really close. Let me I need to. Oh my god. I wonder, did someone else set up? I got really distracted here commenting. Oh yeah, Alde said he needs a break. Okay, I didn't miss anything. Alright, so the next game is gonna be Potoro, Alde, Vanilla, Dushika. Let me switch to a blank scene here. I need to set up this match. Yeah, come on, be good. God is harassing me. Okay, Potoro, Alde, Vanilla, Dushika. Sure. Okay, go back into the tourney here. Match hasn't started yet. Turn the blank thing off. Go back to the window. Oh, thank you, 29. I hope that my commentary isn't terrible, in addition to having a nice voice. okay. Gonna be a few minutes before the game starts. Yeah, someone needed a few minutes of a break, so we're gonna be waiting for the 5-minute delay. I think Anui is busy doing grading or something, or else they might join me on the commentary. It's been too bad. Like, we haven't had Anui on commentary in a long time. It's because it's being so busy with various stuff. Be nice if we could manage to drag Anui back in here sometime. It's not just me. I need someone to point out when I'm making dumb mistakes and stuff. So yeah, this might be the last game. If Anil and Alde win, that'll be it. some Deadly Premonition music. Oh boy. Deadly Premonition, heavily inspired by Twin Peaks. Is relevant because we were thinking about watching some David Lynch films in the server. Or at least I was thinking about it. I don't know if anyone else wants to watch like Eraserhead and Twin Peaks and whatever else. Dune, 1984 Dune. Watch it. And that old Japanese horror movie called House. I want to watch that too. I haven't seen that. Because Izuka wanted to watch The Ring, or Ringu, either one. And that made me think of that other movie I wanted to watch. I think Hiraya wanted to watch The Revenant. Is it called The Revenant or Revenant? I've seen that already. It was okay. See, I think that Vanilla and Alde have talked a lot about strategy and stuff. So that may give them a pretty big advantage. I think that... I'm not sure, like, when I think about it... Yeah, I mean, definitely... If you work together, you can do a lot to, like, shut the other team out. If they're not using the same level of cooperation. I think that if both teams are cooperating, strategies can really be counteracted very heavily. Like say you get ahead by a bunch of points, or you get ahead by a significant amount of points, you just say, okay, we're going to play defensively, shut out the other team. Like the other team can respond to that. And they can work together in order to like counteract that strategy. I think there's certainly if you have an advantage, then there's a limited ability to respond to that, but I think that it kind of ends up being a similar thing to like a 4-player game if you have the same like level of cooperation in terms of the advantage that you get. But if the other team is not cooperating that well, then I think you can just stomp them. So yeah, I think definitely it gives a huge advantage if you have discussed it more, specific strategies to use. Because if you're putting a lot of thought into it, if you're not coordinated and using the same strategies, knowing what your teammate is doing in specific situations, you're really heavily disadvantaged compared to the other team if they're doing that. I think it's really interesting. Maybe after this tourney is over, we can have some heavy discussion of that, some specific strategies, because people may not want to discuss it as much while the tourney is actually going. So yeah, I think it'd be really cool if people have some insights that they've learned. I certainly talked about some stuff like that, but me and Cynthia didn't really discuss strategy too much. Maybe that's my fault. Maybe I should have initiated some more discussion. But I feel like Cynthia doesn't take the tourneys too seriously, so I didn't want to like put pressure on her and stuff. And I just wanted the tourney to be fun. So other people may have a better idea. Let's see. What's going on here? The hell is going on? Not too much. Like, really middling hands. Yeah. Come on, something interesting needs to happen. That's a good draw. Trying to do that Kanchan. Yeah, actually, Potoro could end up with the Itsu here. Not too far from that. And yeah, Dushika's hand kind of shaping up. Yeah, got some nice shapes there. And Alde going straight for Honisu. The hands are actually shaping up pretty well. Vanilla holding onto that south. I wonder if Vanilla kind of feeling like Alde's got this. And is holding on to like safe tiles and stuff, thinking more defensively. Like if the hand comes, then it comes. If not, then just dropped it. It's not like it was particularly safe. Potoro considering the Ricci on the 3-pin. No. Ricci on the 2. Yeah, 6-7, 8-7, 8-9. Yeah, it's Tanki Wei on the 2. As dealer, could get some luck here and get like a 7,700 point hand. Just from an Ura. If with a direct hit off Alda or Vanilla, or with a Tsumo, could get 12,000 points. So we'll see. Perfectly good. I think that looking at this, I wonder. Oh yeah, the one pin would have been Huriten. there's only two twos left. I don't know. I'm not sure if I would have taken this. I think there's a fair amount of upgrades for like a Nobaton weight or whatever. Basically going into a a headless Ishan 10, right? Usually that gives you a fair amount of possibility. Well, not necessarily Ishan 10. I'm trying to think back. So yeah, I mean, there's no real reason to keep that 1-2, is there? Like, I mean, you could draw the 3-pin and get a Nobaton. But yeah, may as well just keep that Tenpai regardless. But are people folding? So Alde just dropped the 1-pin. Certainly didn't need that going for Honitsu. We'll see if Alde is willing to drop that 6. And drawing the 7. Alde just being aggressive here. Going for this Honitsu. Not a very value. I guess it can be a toy, but could call that 5 and get a single weight on the 8. Like, it's getting so late. Oh, there's the Tenpai. 6-9 for just a 3 Han hand for Alde. So whether what comes out first, the 2 or the 6 or the 9. And Vanilla could try and deal in on purpose. and would be successful at doing that. Because the most obvious thing to drop would be that six, which would deal in. And maybe, Alde dropping out of Tenpai. Okay. Didn't want to put down that one. Oh, there we go. Put it all wins. We'll see if there's any Ura. Very significant if there are or not. No, no Ura. Yeah. So it just turns out to be a small hand. Right. Okay, getting this double east, that's pretty good. Pretty decent hand here since it can open. Whether or not Potato gets that east is pretty significant. Eight mon, not useless. Yushika also has a very nice hand. 7, 8, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, very, very nice. Look like two away, but just due to bad shapes. And Alde also has a pretty nice hand. Bit of garbage there. Yeah, Alde and Yushika basically the same situation. But we'll see if Pororo manages to race. If I was Pororo, I would really consider taking that 3-so. Just to try and rush. There is the issue that maybe the East doesn't come out if you do that. Because especially when you have a partner, even if you don't win, your partner might win. So if you are feeling sketchy about something like the double east, you may just not drop it. Yeah, now, oh shit. I didn't even realize. Okay. Well. Right, yeah, so again, the game is pretty close. Hey, cat. This cat is really harassing me. Oh wow, look at this. Pretty really nice mon shapes. I guess this is a hand that looks honitsu, but like it also looks like, I don't know, like it just doesn't have enough tiles in it. Can we play 6-tile version of Mahjong and just keep the ones in the furthest left? If Alde draws like any of those honor tiles. But I think that's probably a good decision to just drop them because, like, yeah, only having like 6 good tiles to start with, like, kind of rough to go for Honitsu in that situation. But could have dropped this 9 pin. It's not useful. And if Alde did start drawing honor tiles, and very quickly get a Honitsu as dealer. What do the other hands look like? I'm getting really focused on this hand. And oh, well, there's a hand that's in Tenpai, which is just a Ricci only hand. Waiting on 4-7. And Vanilla has what? Has a Sanmenchan weight on Pinfu. Simple's Pinfu. Mentan Pin. So yeah, Vanilla really has the advantage here. Gonna end this dealership and maybe get like a Mangan with luck. Doesn't have any Dora or anything, so yeah. Just a base 3 Han hand. But Sumo would not be enough because it's Sumo Pinfu is basically still a 3 Han hand, even though it's technically 4 Han. Because it's only 20 Fu. A lot of pairs. And hold on, 1, 2, 3, that's 4 pairs. So I was wondering if for a second Alde was thinking of Chitoy. All right, steal and Rishi stick. All right. What do you want, cat? Well, Alde has a really nice hand here. Really nice mon tiles again. not necessarily a nice hand. And Vanilla getting double east. Could get could get Honitsu. I wouldn't instantly give up on Honitsu, but I'm probably just double East Endora. If that two mon can be used. Yushika might be able to end this with those Haku. And so, same with Pororo with those Hatsu. Pororo's hand looks pretty good, actually. And maybe he's thinking of like a 3-Han Honitsu. Some chance of an Itsu at full straight. Oh, yeah, just going for whatever now. Yeah, after having drawn next to that Dora, just give up on that Honitsu. Really not worth the loss in efficiency for one extra Han. Oh, yeah, can you, come here. Okay, and vanilla opening, whoops. Yeah, maybe thinking of Honitsu here really depends on, oh yeah, drew a Dora, huh? That's really, really good for, yeah, that one mon not too useful, though. Yeah, it's really hard to make use of that. And I don't know. I feel like, given the Devil East and the Dora, like really the focus should be on efficiency here. There is the fact that East just may never come, which means that a Yaku is needed. But I don't know if it's worth getting rid of a tile like the five. Well, the five pin also has Hurricane issues. But I mean, that six didn't necessarily need to be dropped to begin with. I think, yeah, like, this is a hand as dealer, if that East comes out, yeah. But yeah, didn't happen. Just ending the dealership, that's pretty, a little sketchy. If it were me, I don't know. I don't know if I'd want to take a hand like that. I might
that
just be thinking.
Not a good sumo.
Yeah. Yeah, because it also takes points away from the dealer, even ends the dealership, and there's a chance it could just go to exhausted, which would be a lot better than just winning that small number of points. And ideally, vanilla would win something. Take out. I do think it becomes very hard to judge when the specific situation. Your partner. Is the dealer. You have a small hand. You can end the round, move the game along. You're in the lead already. Oh, they're not in the lead. Yeah, they're behind. Yeah, given that they're behind, yeah, I think that's pretty, like, you need to take advantage of these dealerships while you have them. Moving the game along just hurts you. Dushika? Having some symmetric so shapes here. 3, 5, 6, 7, 9. Pretty good. the hand in general, not so good. Pororo. Can't call the oh yeah, it's still East round. Okay, so yeah, those East will open, but again, that's gonna be a tiny hand. Like if I'm Pororo, I'm thinking like, what can I even do with this hand that's useful? Can't feed Yushika. And, like, need to stay closed, at least, I think. So maybe just want to get rid of those Easts. Because it's hard to get any value except by drawing a third one. But maybe could get, like, a Mentan Pin or something. So, yeah, if it were me, I might have just dropped those Easts early. Because opening doesn't really do anything except maybe pressure the opponents. Maybe. But even the opponents aren't going to care about. Well, the five mon Dora is a little scary because you don't know who has the red five or who has a couple red five in their hand that are just easy to use. So yeah, opening on the East could be a little scary to the opponents. But yeah, you definitely have to consider like what Alde did. Yeah, the tiny sumo ending the dealership. You want to avoid that kind of stuff. Although, I mean, it is they do have the lead. like I was saying, there is the advantage of just moving the game along and increasing your lead a little bit. Even if it's just a little, it prevents the opponents from winning, brings you closer to victory. Makes it hard to judge whether you should even consider it or not. As the game goes on, you may get a better idea that your opponent or that your partner isn't going to win. If you get hints of that, then maybe you could just prevent damage. It was very complicated. A lot of things to consider. And how far away is Yushika? Yushika's hand has advanced a lot, but still going into the third row. Oh, Drew dropped the 3-so there. Hold on. Oh, yeah, Vanilla Ricci'd. Vanilla Ricci'd several turns ago. And the 3-so was the 3-so? I mean, the 3-so isn't. Right, hold on. 3, 4, 5, 1, 2. Oh, yeah. The 3-so is safe because it was dropped by Alda. Okay. Miscounting the number of tiles there. Yeah, I was a little bit mystified by that 3-so drop for a bit. It seemed like it was just a really dangerous tile. Yeah, nothing Yushika can do here. Just needs to not deal in. Oh, that's too bad. That's not going to really affect the placements at all, is it? Yeah, so Porodo and Yushika still have the lead here by a significant amount. They have first and third, so they have a lead from Uma. And they also have a lead in terms of average score by a couple thousand points, a few thousand points. Specifically 3,100 points, 3,100 point lead. Or it's double that, isn't it? Hold on. So it's going to be 6,200 point lead, but they're 3,100 above 60K if you add their scores together. And Yushika, pretty close here. Well, is one away for like a single wit on the Dora. If Yushika draws the Dora, that would obviously be very nice for them. Well, I mean, okay. Let me look at more than one hand. Porodo also one away for a Champon wait on a Honitsu hand. If that East comes out. So if Alde drops that East, we'll have a, that will be 1, 2, that'll be 4-han. A 4-han Honitsu. Yeah, and there it came out. Came out from Vanilla, right? Yeah, waiting on the 3 in the West, not a bad wait. The opponents might be pretty scared to drop the West. They could start Homebo farming. If Yushika drafts the West, just assume they'll get a billion repeats. Oh, Sumo. Okay. Well, that's good. That is a score that hits Yushika a little bit, but it's about, I think it's a little bit better than the Sumo you would get with like Sumo, or it's about exactly the same because they get net 8,000 points, which is the same you would get in Sanma with Sumo loss. I need to move over to the right. The dealer. Okay. Yeah, if they win this, that means there'll be a third game. If Alde and Vanilla pull out a win here, then in that case, that will end it. Check out the chat. I just don't have anyone talking in chat. You can also check out the Discord. Okay. All right. distracted there for a second. Oh, and I missed the entire round. Okay. Yep. Yeah, so another somewhat sketchy sumo, but it's fine because, like, they're going into South 2. And they've got a significant lead. And also got a few points from that. Not a lot, but some number. All right, so Vanilla. Vanilla's hand looks pretty good, doesn't it? Got the 7-8. It's all right. Yushika can open on the Hatsu and take that Hatsu from Pororo. Pororo is willing to put that down. Pororo also has a pretty decent looking hand. Let's see who gets lucky on the drop on the draws here. Oh, and the Hatsu comes out, as we would expect. How far away is Dushika? Still doesn't really have completed shapes. But open. And what is... So Vanilla can't currently use that 5, so that might come out. We assume that Dushika gets that. That brings Yushika pretty close. Oh, but that 3 connects to the 5. Maybe it'll stick around for a while. And Pororo's hand. Very far advanced now. It's 1 away, right? Like, if Pororo draws the 4, so that'll be a weight on the 4-7 mon. Now is waiting on. Well, no, hold on. No. That got rid of the pair. So now it just has a headless Ishan 10. And Vanilla getting that Nakabukure shape, and what happened to the? Oh, the 5 went into a chi. Hold on a second here. I got a ping from my work chat here. Better check my email too. Right, nothing, not too much going on today since this is just ended this break. Okay, Cat. Getting a lot of distractions here. Ah, boy. Come on. And I need to, Yuki, is listening, right? Maybe if I'm too slow, if I'm too slow to start the next game, maybe Yuki could queue it up for me with the groups I have, listed out there in the Discord. This game is gonna end pretty soon.
Okay.
Ah, boy. They're asking me to work more. I want to work less. I want less hours. Work 1 hour a week. I don't really feel like I'm working part time as it is. Okay, enough complaints. What if they find my Twitch? I need to be careful. Who knows what resources they have to find people's Twitch accounts and such? Who knows? Okay. What's going on? The dealership has changed. We're in South 3. Dushika and Vanilla. Find. I need to be watching the Discord in case the game ends. Oh, boy. Yeah, he was saying in the chat that, yeah, like, when you're in the lead, sumos are good. When you're behind, sumos are bad. That's kind of what I said, but Yeah, there's also a cost to not letting the dealer win when they're on your team. But that cost may be kind of like, then if you look at the discards, how things are progressing, you might feel like they're not going to win, or you might feel like they are. So that's probably like may determine whether you take that sumo or not. And whether you think that it will go to exhaustive or it won't, like I think it is very difficult to make this decision, because if you are 90% sure they're not going to win, and if you're 70% sure that one of the opponents will by the time it gets to exhaustive, then you may as well take, like, you may be pretty inclined to take anything at that point. So, yeah, I think it's pretty hard. Okay. So Vanilla said, okay. I don't know what that means. Alde said, I'll be right back. So we're going to have another break here, so that's fine. Maybe they'll still be on break when this game ends. But I mean, I guess that spoils what's going to happen. They're going to lose. Vanilla and Alde, not going to pull this out. Unless they just misunderstand. There's still the possibility that they'll win, and that they just don't realize that that means that they win the tourney. I'm desperately trying to avoid spoilers here through this tortured logic. Well, it's not really tortured. It's fine. It's fine logic. I just don't buy it. Okay, what's going on? Right, Vanilla has a dealership. Vanilla is one away from a Chanta, from a Junchan. So needs that needs like needs a 9-so or another 9-pin. Kind of limited ability to win here. Needs some specific tiles. Would be helpful to get a 1-pin, because then could drop this 9 and end up waiting on the 1 if the, well there's only, that would be, oh, the ones are dead. So that's not helpful. Not helpful. I mean, if Vanilla drew another 1, then would not be able to wait on it. Okay. Just a Chitoy going into all last. They can, Yushka and Pororo could probably just fold. Given that Yushka has a dealership, like, in order for Alde and Vanilla to win, they need to get their score above 60k points on average, which means they need like a Baemon. Well, not a Baemon. To get their score above 60k points on average, not on average, in total. Yeah, they need to get their points above 60k. And to do that, yeah, they're going to need almost 20k points. So they need a Baemon. I think a Baemon wouldn't even be enough, would it? Let's see. Because if you add their points together, if you add in the Rishi's stick, it's 1900 plus 23-1, which is well, it doesn't matter. They're not going to get that. This couldn't have possibly done it, right? I guess if it was Ipatsumo Urusan, is Urusan possible? No, it isn't, right? I don't think this could have been Baemon. See, I think that was kind of hopeless, wasn't it? Even if it was a direct hit, like it would need to be a direct hit, and well, that doesn't seem right. No, I'm being dumb. I'm being so dumb. They don't need a Baemon. I don't know what's wrong with me. I don't know how to do math. I was looking at the difference in their score, and I didn't know what I was thinking. Yeah, they needed 10,000 points is what they needed. So yeah, or no, I don't know what I'm thinking. I don't know what I'm thinking. I'm hopeless. The game is over. We know what happened. Right? Just confirm this. Yeah. Pororo Jishika. Was what I said originally correct? And I just got confused because I was looking at the scores after the score was added on. I'm just becoming hopelessly confused here. I think they did need a Baemon. it was possible that they could just get a Yakumon. Like Alda could have gotten a Yakumon, or a Suanko, often a Suanko as possible. Okay, so they want to go to the next match. Let me see. It's going to be Vanilla, Pororo, Alda, Yushka. Let me pause here. Okay. Going to be Vanilla, Alda. Hold on. I did this wrong. Vanilla. Wait. I'm doing this wrong. Vanilla, Pororo, Alda, Yushka. There we go. And there's someone named Seacac. He's not part of the tourney, I think. Just sort of maybe just watching the game or something. Well, they're queued up. Match has not started yet. Okay. Let me go into switch this back here. The window. Okay. So this will be the last game unless it's a tie. Ties are possible, they're just extremely unlikely. Right. Yeah, so just coming down this last game. Showdown. Whoever wins this wins the whole tourney. Pretty climactic. We'll see if the last game is climactic or not. It may just be one team like wins gets like a 100,000 point lead. Yes, Uma is factored in, yes. Often the Uma doesn't matter because it seems like almost always we end up in this situation. Okay, what are you doing? For some reason, I don't know why. It almost always turns out that we have first and fourth on one team and then second and third on the other. Maybe that's down to team dynamics somehow. I don't know why it would turn out that way. Maybe there's a reason. Well, the music isn't playing anymore. Okay, come on. Ah, oh, jeez. This cat is just never stops harassing me. Whenever I'm talking on the microphone, just has to come over here and sit right in my face. Till I just give up and put her out of the room. You know. Off caps lock. Yeah, we don't consider seeding. Like the seeding actually. Because of the way that we determined the team, like the first and last dealer are on the same team, so there isn't really a way to score based on seeding to break up a tie. So we would just if there's a tie, it's just a tie. At least that's the way that Anui decided to do it. Maybe there's a way to do a tiebreaker, but I mean it's so unlikely to happen that the scores are exactly the same. Coming down to given that the average scores on both teams have to tie up. Which is a lot less likely than having two people with the same score. I think, right? Or is it the same likelihood? I think it's less likely. It hasn't happened so far. It may happen now. What if it happens now? What a nightmare. Oh, did it happen in Washizu? Yeah, it happened. Yeah, if we get a tie, we're just gonna have to play another game. And they may even say, like, no, we're not going to. Screw you. And schedule it another time. That's fine. Just delaying the showdown for dramatic effect. But yeah, it would be very surprising if that happened right now. The very last game of the tourney. Start. All right, here we go. Right, show of hands, the tile, okay. And now the opponents are across the table from each other because of the third game. So the first game, the first dealer was on one team. The second game, the first dealer was on the other team, and the third game, they're across from each other. So we've done all of these, and Vanilla having a pretty good hand here to start with, and Alde as well. Both of them have. Yeah, Alde could get a San Menchan there. Seems unlikely to get a Mentan pin. Not particularly unlikely. I'm just thinking, even if the four pin is drawn, I still have to avoid drop and getting the one pin in there at any point. Not unlikely though. Ororo's hand advancing pretty well. Undushika just getting a nice draw next to the 3-mon. All those pin tiles. Wrapping off that 3. Okay. Kind of a weird 1-1, 2-2, 3-4-5, yeah. Gat can develop in a lot of ways. Oh, and drawing a triple there. Is that... That's not Tenpai, is it? Yeah, 7, 3, 4, 5, 1. That's Ishan 10. It's a pretty nice Ishan 10. Have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hidden in there, but also the 1-1 as a pair. We can use the pair on either side. Can fit a 6 in there, or fit more stuff in the middle. So yeah. Oh, and there's the Tenpai, yeah. Waiting on the 3-6. It's a Richie only hand. Little Richie Dora. I may need to get rid of this cat. I don't know if the cat can actually be heard. I think that when even if she like meows, that the voice gets filtered out because it's considered noise. Which is honestly pretty insulting. And my cat is noise. Thanks. Okay. And Alde, Alde is still like two away, isn't he? Doesn't matter. Potoro getting the Potoro getting that sumo and stealing that Rishi stick. Or keeping the Rishi stick on their team. And ends Vanilla's Delicious, so that's perfectly fine, yeah. Because if it had gone to exhaustive, that would leave them with a dealership. So that sumo seems perfectly okay. Do you have to worry about? Well, yeah, because yeah. You should get another dealership and all that. Yeah. That's perfectly fine. This is a really nice hand that Potoro has. Really fast anyway. Can open right away into a headless Ishanten. Maybe better just to reach E. And you have a chance at getting Ipeko. Have a chance at reaching Ipeko. As dealer, getting any more on top of that makes it pretty good. Especially if can't really fit a Dora in here or anything. Can't really get more value. I mean, ideally, like draw the Yakuhai and then draw the 8, and have a pair somewhere. How about these three tiles? Draw the Hatsu, draw 7 so, and draw the 8 pin. That's a lot. That's all I'm asking. Yeah, that 9 not really helpful. What are the other hands like though? So, okay, Richie with chance free pickle. If that 8 comes out, the 8 is what's more likely to come out. Alde having a couple of Dora there, and is 1 away. It's kind of a bad 1 away. And how far away is Vanilla? Vanilla is pretty far away. And so is Dushika, so it looks like it's between these two. Well, Dushika, well, hold on. Dushika is in Tenpai, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. Why did I say that? No. 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 5, 7. Yeah, Dushika is 1 away. And has the option to drop off that Kanchan there. Better than dropping off like the three so. Have to worry about Harita and stuff. You drop that 3 so. Seems a lot better to just get rid of this Kanchan entirely. Oh, and drawing the 7 again. That would have been Tenpai. Or would it? I don't think. Well, no. Right, well, hold on. This could become a 3-way Tanki way. If Dushika draws the 4-so and drops the 5, we'll be waiting on the 1-4-7 3-way Tanki wait. We'll just be Richie only, though. Okay, come on. And is it even worth reaching at this point, even for a 3-way wait? Okay. Oh boy. Would that have been Tenpai? I guess not. Yeah, the Yusha's hand is just a little awkward. Just doesn't manage to get into Tenpai. Potoro just never Potoro just never getting that 8, that 5 or 8. Still valuable. And again, like they have the first and fourth, like that always just seems to happen. But it's not like, I don't think it's anything like the teams cooperating and like one person getting points and the other person not getting points, because you don't have the ability to do that. It just somehow seems to work out that way. Let me let this cat out of my room. What does Al they have here? Oh, this hand looks pretty fast. Pretty, it's like a simples hand. If that. I mean, if Al draws a 7, it's not. But, and also, the 9 is the door, isn't it? So, yeah. If Al they draws another 9, then it has some value. Otherwise, it's kind of hard to use this. Oh, and there's another triple. Maybe this will be Salanko. Or just waiting on the 7, okay. Didn't realize that was 10 by actually. Pororo, playing all the Dora. So Pororo is the dealer. You can see half the Dora here is open on the Chun. It has to worry about Sumo. So there's some reason to push. Getting rid of dropping the ones. Safety. Yeah, and gets hit by this Sumo. F hit. Not that big a deal. Alde's in first now? Okay. So now it's not first and fourth anymore, is it? Yeah, now for once we have it goes first, second, third, fourth. So the second and fourth are in the same team. But that's usually a temporary situation. Maybe this one time it'll actually stay that way. Now they having a nice fast hand here. Might be some temptation to go for Honitsu, but yeah, not gonna happen. One away from just like a Haku Dora hand. Maybe keep this closed. Nice 6-7-8, 6-7-8. 7-8-8 shape. Develop a lot of ways. But this is like perfect fusion. But is Alde going to call the Haku? And well, wait on the one. Not really. Well, yeah. The Dushka, yeah, just drop that Haku. And Alde. Actually, going for Honitsu. Okay. not wanting just to have a 2 on hand here. I mean, there is the possibility of getting another 6, which would bring it up to a bit higher value. We'll see if this Honitsu actually completes. That would have been the win there. If Pororo, I mean, you can't predict. Pororo may not have reacted the same way. May have the fact that these pintiles were dropped. Well, I mean, it's not going to make it more likely for the Pororo. So yeah, probably would the same thing would have happened. But yeah, I think that we're like at the time that Alde decided to switch to go for Honitsu, like it's already getting pretty late. I don't know if it's worth the risk that you just don't in the hand. Because it's still so far away. And given that you have the option to just win. Was that Tenpai? Yeah. That's a Dianchi wait. Waiting on the 6-7-9. Nine's most. Yeah, Dianmin plus Tanki. So you either either have a tanki weight on the 7 or the dianmen weight. 7-8. Or including the 7-8 for the 7-9. Very nice. Should I just still keep calling these the triple plus one? It is just as a... I don't know. I kind of like calling it Yanki. It's just fun. Oh, but yeah, Yushika ended up winning. So, yeah. Alde delayed, like, all the way to... didn't get an attempt by into the third row. Had a chance for a Mangan. That would be worth 12,000. But could have won a... like a... would it have been a Tuhan hand? That could be what decides the game. Really risky. Big gamble. It could have worked out for them. Big gamble. Yushika starting out with two triples here. Could end up this hand is very far advanced, but is missing a pair. Could get another one of these triple plus one weights. Which should be a kanki. Waiting on the 2-3. Anshan. And Yushika could just open up here and wait on the and get that weight on the 2-3 red if the 4 comes out. But that would just be a one-hon hand. So this is a situation where I feel like maybe the other way. Maybe you need to not open there. And wait for the Ricci, given how much more valuable it is. I'm not really sure about that. You take the in plus extra dealer turn, or do you hold out for a Ricci that could theoretically even reach Mangan if you get lucky? Here we got the choice, but yeah, skipped it. And I mean, this can also just become a Itsu. Itsuhaku. That would just be Tuhan, but if we get the Ricci, that could be huge. Could get Hanuman. And there we go. But here's the option to go into Dama for 3 Han. Dama for 3 Han. Ricci. I think you have to Ricci here, because what if you don't get the 1? Oh. And also not taking the possibility... Not waiting on the 1-4, waiting on the 3-way Tanki weight on the 2-5-8. So this is just Ricci Haku. With a bunch of Fu. Yeah, this is a lot of Fu. It's a closed, this is worth 8, right? And this is worth 4, so that's 12 Fu. So it's going to be over 50 Fu here. With a minimum 2 Han. If it's, say, it's Sumo, that'll be pretty big, I think. It'd be worth like over 9,000 points or something. I don't know how much it's worth. 50 Fu, 3 Han is dealer. But it's more than a regular manga, I think. It's 40 Fu is 7,700. So yeah. Yeah, interesting choice, yeah. Because yeah, going for the weight on the 1-4, it's a smaller weight, but if you win on the 1, that's an extra 2 Han on there. But it's unlikely to reach Hanuman. So if it reaches Mangan, that's just 12,000 points. So is it worth? But also, what's the difference between 2-5-8 and 1-4? How much better is 2-5-8 given that it doesn't include the 1? Are 1s dead? Well, they are. Poro has all of them. but of course, Yushika doesn't know that. Yeah, it's going to be very hard for them to... Well, we're almost at the end of the... It'd be very hard for them to actually try and win while not dropping any of the ones. Looks like we're just going to... Unless Poro just decides to drop the 1. No, not going to drop the Hockey. Oh, and Alde had a chance to deal in there. But no real reason to. Yeah. Okay. Just 3,000 points. I don't think the one of the four came out, did it? Well, the one came out here yet, but not from the opposing team. Probably better to just get that 3,000 points from everybody than rather than taking them from your own teammate. Because yeah, I guess this is maybe this is what leads to the 1-4 situation. The fact that like you can deal into your teammate, so that increases the difference in score naturally, something like that. Oh, Nishika having a nice hand here again from the start. Is this already Ishan 10? Is there a tile here that gives Tenpai? I don't think so. I think it's two way. It's just a really nice. Alright, what else is going on? Vanilla having two Dora in a pretty decent hand. A lot of pairs. 1, 2, 3, 4. Vanilla could end up going for Chitoy or Tortoy or something, depending on, but that 3 makes it less likely. We'll see. You can easily go one way or the other. Like, suppose Vanilla draws another 3 cell. Suppose draws another a 1 or a 2, something like that. Puts Vanilla Ishan 10 for Chitoy with 2 Dora. Might have to feel like he has to go that way. Oh, and there's a triple. So yeah, if now Vanilla draws another pair, will be both Ishan 10 for Chitoy and have the ability to call into Ishan 10 for Tortoy. And yeah, there we go. That's the situation we have. Yeah, but dealt in the Porto. And Yushika's hand just didn't advance at all. Nothing happened. And a nice win from Pororo. But ends their dealership. Yeah, it does take a points from the opponent, though. So that's always a good win, and they do have the lead. And look at Vanilla's hand here. Thinking about going for Honisu, but decides to maybe we'll decide to do it now, though, having drawn that north. Yeah, changes his mind, decides to go for Honisu. Still has the option to not, though. And it's also worth more being possibly closed. But I'm sure that taking that can also open. So yeah, if Nell's now Ishan 10, can wait on the Haku or the Hatsu, or draw one of those and wait on the 5, so... So yeah, very good position that Vanilla's in here. And Yushika not getting that Haku. And Pororo, how far away is Pororo? Oh, has Ipeko in hand. But it's still, hold on. 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, interesting. So yeah, Pororo's still two away. Another 3, huh? Okay. That is one away, so could drop this 9 pin. And have some really nice acceptance in Ishan 10, right? Ishan 10 where you can draw the 4 or the 7, you can also draw like the 1 or the 2 or the 4 or the 5. In order to get nice shapes here. But yeah. Does that do it? I don't think so, right? I'm a little confused with these shapes. There's just too many 3s. deciding to drop the... So going into a sort of... A lot of different things that can be the head here. Like we can have 3s as the head, or the 1s or the 2s. But yeah, very good acceptance. And so if the, like the 4 pin is drawn, could like drop a... What do you drop? Because I feel like there's just too many pairs now. Like that's not Tenpai. It's like, I think that... Yeah. Needed to get rid of one of those pairs. It's just weird developments here. Vanilla still not in Tenpai? Just didn't get anything here. And how far away is Yushiko with that draw? Open on the Haku, but still won't be in Tenpai. Again, has too many pairs over here too. Both teammates having that difficulty. And Alde and Vanilla both having the Chun tiles. But it's too late in the game now. It seems like just nobody's gonna get the Tenpai here. Kotaro isn't in Tenpai, right? 1-1, 2-2-2, 3-3-3-3. But hold on. 1-1, 2-2, 3-3, and then 3-3-3, and then yeah. Is that Tenpai? No, because the fight's, yeah. This just, yeah, just didn't work out. None of these hands are working out. This is going to be a go to exhaust if nobody in Tenpai. I don't know if I've ever seen that happen in one of these team games so far. It looks like Vanilla isn't going to make it. Hold on, we can look at this as 1, 2, 3, 3, 3, 3, and then a Penchon, and then 3, 5, 6, 6, so it's one away. It's just some bad shapes here because, like, I don't know. Can we think of this as, what, like these 4-3s are just not working very well here. I think the dropping that 4 really hindered the use of these 3s. Oh, Alde did get an attempt by, okay. Okay, going into South 2. And yeah, they've got a pretty decent lead. Well, actually, hold on, if we look at the Uma, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. So they've got second and third place. So what does that mean with regard to Uma? It's like plus 15 and minus 5 gives them plus 10, and it's plus 5, minus 5. Hold on. Hold on. Yeah, this is the same. This is first and fourth. I don't know what I'm thinking about. Second and third, first and fourth, they all equal out. So it's just average score. Is that right? Yeah. I don't know why I was so confused there. So yeah, it's just average score. So Ryushka and Poruro are ahead by a significant number of points. Like 15,000 or something. All right. I think it's like 17,000 ahead. well, you can just see they're ahead of. That's not right because they have. If you add their scores together, they've got 60,000 plus 1,700 plus 1,200 is going to be 62,900. So they're going to be like 5,000 points ahead. Yeah. I just added something wrong. So they're like 5,000 points ahead. It's pretty close here. And Alde winning off of Vanilla, so again keeping the game close, but they're still behind. Yeah, I really think Alde shouldn't have taken that. That doesn't help them at all, except in the sense that it gives them the dealership. But if Alde had chosen not to take that, gone to Hariten for one turn, could have still won off of Yushiko Poruro. But you just need, that's a situation where you need to decide what to do in advance and say, okay, if my partner deals in, I'm going to instantly skip. Or you hit no call before it gets to the turn and then turn it back on. Or, I mean, I guess you could just, that doesn't work, does it? no call doesn't work for run at all, does it? I'm not sure if it does. Or does it just work, or do you have to just hit the run button if you want to, I don't know. I feel like probably it doesn't work with run. But regardless, you need to make sure that the opposing team does not know that you skipped on a run. Because yeah, if Valde had hit the opposing team with that, that would just turn the tables instantly. So I think that was a missed opportunity there. And Vanilla still could have won. So yeah. Unless you really need to kill the dealer's hand, like, right, instantly. I think you would normally just skip that. Being behind. What's that deal on to? This under Dushka. Okay. Yeah, things not looking good for Alde and Vanilla. They need to win a pretty big hand here. Because they're now significantly behind. They're behind by 14k. Am I doing this edition correctly? Kororo and Yushika together have about 68,000. They have, okay, it's 66 for 67 for 68.1. So they're ahead by like 16,200 points, if I added that right. So yeah, I think that even a direct hit with a Mangan is not going to be enough. So Yushika and Pororo can just fold here. Accept the win. If Dushika was just dealt a great hand, could just take it, but and increase the make it so they need the Hanuman instead of the manga. Or even the Mangan wouldn't be enough, so is that correct? Like if Alde hit one of these two with a Mangan. Well, okay, here, if Vanilla hit Pororo, that wouldn't be enough because it wouldn't change their placement. But if the points are a bit different, and maybe it would change the placement. But I believe, yeah, it's not going to be... They're going to need the Hanuman here. Dushika was Torichi, Dushika or Pororo with Torichi, and then they win a manga, they steal a Rishi stick. I think that would be enough. Or would it? I think it would. I might be wrong because like I'm not doing the math or anything. I'm just basing this on their average scores that I calculated a second ago. But yeah, definitely looking like Yushika and Pororo will just win here. Are they trying to win the round? It looks to me like Yushika isn't doing like Sakigiri or anything. Or trying to keep like safe tiles against... Yushika is dropping pin tiles, right? Now they... Could be going for a Honitsu here. It could theoretically reach Hanuman and Dama. Yeah, I definitely expect if Alde takes this Richi, that Rishika will just... Could this reach Hanuman? So this is South plus Dora, right? That's it. So even with Ura-san, unless we see a Khan here, I don't think it's possible to get a Hanuman. Oh boy. Yushika just wanted a hard fold here. Alright. That's gonna be the end of the game. Need to confirm that the scores are going to give Yushika and Pororo the win. So they have a positive score. Yushika and Pororo together, a bit above zero. Alde and Vanilla, a little bit below zero. So yeah, definitely congrats to Yushika and Pororo. They won the tourney. Vanilla and Alde came in second. So congratulations. That'll be the end of the tourney. And I don't know what we've got planned next. Usually by this point, we've already got a plan. I think we've been kind of busy. We might take a little break from tourneys for a bit. Maybe not. We'll see. It's normally Anui who does a lot of the tourney, like sort of initial planning stuff, and I tend to do more of the scheduling. Yeah, but we'll just see what we design to do and what people are interested. So yeah, that'll be that. Thanks everybody for playing. Oh, just go and put it over in the voice chat. Congrats on winning the tourney. Champions. Team champions. Yeah, I should probably get back to doing my work and whatnot. But thanks a lot. Nice seeing you guys play. Very good job. Went through all the way, won every single time. Never lost a single round. I guess Vanilla not too pleased with the result. They did well as well. They did well also. Okay. So I'm going to end the stream. Thanks everybody for participating in the tourney. We'll let you know what's coming up next. That'll be that.